My name is Rick Russell. I'm the production director at Seacoast Church. Seacoast is a multi-campus church, started in the Charleston, South Carolina area, and we have campuses all the way from Asheville throughout most of South Carolina. We have 13 campuses currently on 12 physical locations. We stream to each of those campuses every single weekend live. So from a leadership perspective at Seacoast, our number one most important priority from a production team is to provide the best quality video and the best quality playback at our campuses. With our previous streaming solution, probably once a week we would have one of the 12 locations drop out. And in our case, a dropout would either mean switch to a backup message that was a video file that we would send to those campuses, or it would entail a campus pastor having to get up on stage and try and preach a message that he'd never spoken before.
I remember many times, and it isn't funny, but I remember many times being a campus pastor, sitting in the front row, and as you sit in the front row, and all of a sudden you look, and the screen is frozen. And you know, we make fun, but you know, maybe the teaching pastor is just like frozen. And as a campus pastor, you freeze. And it's a terrible, terrible feeling when that screen freezes. Not so much that, oh, I gotta get up there and, you know, take the notes and now teach the message, or not so much, I can't make it through this day, what am I gonna say? The hard part is your whole congregation. It sends a lull over the congregation. The whole congregation freezes.
You know, we're working on, you know, either DSL lines or commodity cable connections as our connections to these campuses. So we were really, we kind of thought we were stuck on the platform until I saw a post on social media from another tech director in the area who was trying out Living as One. And I immediately jumped on the phone and called him up and said, so, you know, what's going on? Got a demo in, ran a demo at four or five different campuses over about a month. I tried to pick the worst possible environments that we have here, one of them being a fishing village of about 500 people with a really poor DSL connection, and ended up putting it in there and streamed the entire service and had, you know, no problems at all. And at the end of that month, came back to the leadership and said, hey, I think this is a product we should consider.
And I'm happy, very extremely happy to say we brought in their system, took out all the systems in our locations, put all these at all 13 locations, and it is absolutely amazing the difference we have.
Probably one of the biggest things we've seen from an attender perspective at our campuses is the lack of freezing or smearing or digital distortion that we would see in other streaming solutions that we tried at our campuses.
Some of that was even internet related. So I think one of the great things is there's a buffering time, a buffering system that Living as One has, that it can buffer, the internet can break down and come back up, it can slow down, you can have failures in the internet, but it will still buffer and it will create a smooth, consistent service where we don't have breakdowns in the middle of the screen, or we don't have the same glitches going on the screen as we used to have.
As long as you've got enough of a buffer, it allows you to continue playing back video in a smooth, uninterrupted format. And for us, that's huge. Having campuses in rural areas with not the most reliable internet connections has really helped us be completely successful. That can be a little bit of a negative in, you know, getting as close to live as possible. It's really great on the reliability perspective.
That we're not stressing over the satellite locations, the productions, the video. We can work on other things. We can get better at what we do on Sunday morning as a church. And it has been an extremely, extremely much smoother operation with Living as One. So thank you guys and appreciate all you do.